great for digestion, blood circulation, all the smell. I mean, what do I really know about blood circulation? I might be making that up, but as I will say for the first time, I'm not a medical professional, so don't take any of this to heart. I'm just a general, traditional wife who dabbles in witchery. And so here we are with this paring knife. Oh, another lovely set of items we got as a wedding gift. These beautiful Scandia white knives. Anywho, I'm using this paring knife to slice off the skin of this ginger. Get it nice in its naked raw state. I love to use ginger in all sorts of ways, in cooking or even just cutting it up and putting it in boiling water with some honey or a cinnamon or all sorts of concoctions for health. Now, when I would go home and visit my parents and cook for them, I would put ginger in the meals. Ooh, with vegetables and just simple meals with, you know, rice and more sort of Asian inspired. But my parents still, to this day, when I come home, they're like, oh, are you going to cook something strange and exotic for us? Or you're going to buy some ginger and we're going to be left with this big root of ginger around our house. And I think, well, isn't ginger just a very normal, lovely thing to cook with? I think so. I don't think it's that out of the ordinary. So naturally, I would want to put it in my kombucha too. Another reason I would be surprised that my parents would be surprised. Oh, there it is. All ready to be grated. Anywho, my father loves spicy food, and I got that from him, and so I would only imagine that he would love a sort of, not the ginger, well, I suppose ginger is a sort of, it has a spice, well, it is a spice. Here's that grater. I believe another wedding gift. That's the thing, if you want gifts, you might consider becoming traditionally married. So here I am, being a traditional wife, making homemade kombucha to keep my family healthy. My family basically just being me and my husband. Should we get a cat? No. Shall we get a dog? I would love to. But we just love to travel so much, and I can't bear the thought of my pet missing me, and or needing to put my pet in a kennel. Oh, I couldn't do it. And so for now, I'll just be a childless, catless, traditional wife woman. That works for me. I'm hoping to get out of this ginger, oh, let's say 4 or 5 portions worth, in my bottles to flavor. Now, will I combine it with the lemon? Always a good idea. Ooh. Now, it may be a little amount, but it actually gets quite a pile going there. I think it will be perfect to divvy up. And that's another thing. I like to just put it in raw. I don't need to use a sieve or cut it into big chunks and then try to fish them out. No. I just keep it all in there and drink the pulp. It is very pulpy, it's true. And I will say again, another nice ingredient that I forgot to buy at the store this time, but I'd like to use use in the past is apple juice. Just pour it right in there. Well, not sure what that little goofball was about, but I seem to remember I did buy another juice to flavor the kombucha. This one I tried, and it's tried and true. It is pomegranate juice. I have done it in the past where I actually just took the pomegranate seeds themselves and juiced them. I smushed them in a strainer and got all the juice, and then I realized that just buying the already squeezed juice was a much better use of the time. And here she is, ladies and gentlemen, the queen herself. Last week's batch of kombucha. She's kept in there with the rubber band around a tea towel, which happens to match my dress. Not planned. So now we are washing our hands because I am going to be reaching in and bringing out the mother. And to touch the mother, you need very, very clean hands. I am not a big hand washer person. I mean, I don't like to wash away in general natural oils, but I will wash my hands for the mother very thoroughly. There are all sorts of rules with mother. Mother should never touch metal, and so that's why I have here a glass bowl. Mother can touch plastic, but who really wants to touch plastic? So here we go. Into the glass bowl she goes. She has gotten very thick. No judgment. Shit. making officially the next week's batch. This tea has cooled to room temperature, and we're taking out the loose leaf tea. Of course, with the magic of editing, and this has probably taken quite a long time to cool. Sometimes it can take maybe an hour. Sometimes I put it in the fridge, but believe me, it is cool to room temperature, and I just pour it into the glass jar, and it mixes with that starter liquid, and now we can re-add our mother, our SCOBY. Oh yes, my fingers have been clean this whole time, only touching kombucha, so we're good. And back in the bath she goes. Now, it isn't necessary that mother needs to be floating at the top. Mother will do what mother wants to do. She may bobble, and she may go for little dips down at the bottom of the jar, and no need to worry. She'll be okay, and she's